suspicious marks.
Very good.
May it please the court. Note, I've just placed before the court a very brief note. It has 7 points in it. And these are the 7 points that I just seek to go through very quickly and hopefully within 10 minutes. But I would point out that I had earlier filed a written submission note. I would urge that that note may kindly be examined. That provides the detailed reasons for judgments, case law, and I'd filed a paper book of judgments as well. So kindly, in my earlier note, I would in particular draw attention to paragraphs 6, 7, 9, and 11 of that note. It's not a very long note, but if nothing else, paragraphs 6, 7, 9, and 11 of that note may kindly be examined. Also, as far as the factual issues are concerned, BPTI and Nazriati issue and so on, I've tried to explain those in CMA 5913 of 2024, the circumstances in which that happened. And if I may, I'll very briefly allude to what is stated in this CMA 5913 of 2024, which is on behalf of the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf and Barrister Gohar Khan. It's just to place some facts before the board.
Can you repeat the number, please?
5913 of 2024. This is on behalf of Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf and Barrister Gohar Khan. So, note, if I could just very quickly go through my 7 points.
Yes, 5913.
Hopefully within 10 minutes. And I take the position with a great deal of respect and recognition of what Justice Atar Manila has said, that there is a larger context. But putting that larger context to aside and starting with the presumption that PTI-backed candidates were declared independents in terms of the proviso to Rule 94, that proviso remains on the statute book, and therefore we were treated as independents once elected.
Is there any order regarding all the candidates that all of you are independent?
But in my case, the second...
By the election commission.
One of the second February orders...
Yes, so it's only in respect of your
candidate. But they made a general declaration that anybody who has come in a situation similar to mine, I had filed nomination papers declaring myself to be a PTI candidate, and the election commission said that since the party has been denied...
I think there is no order in respect of all the candidates, but that all of them are independent.
No, but that order lays down the law, the understanding of the law and what happened in reality. I'll just come to that when I come to the factual aspects given in CMA 5913. So the order passed in my case, and even prior to that, on the day 13th of January, we were told that there are two sets of symbols available, those for independents and those for political parties. We could only choose from the set put aside for independents. So it was very clear with the ROs on the 13th of January, and the 2nd February ECP order only confirms that situation, that we were to be treated as independents because of the explanation to Rule 94. Read with the judgment which said that PTI is not entitled to a symbol. So that created us as independents, regardless of what our affiliation in the nomination papers was.
Just clarification of a factual aspect.
Lord.
The record that has been placed before us by the ECP
Lord.
Was contradicted by Mr. Gaur Ali Khan
yes.
when he appeared one day.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you confirm?
Yes, Murad. Kindly see, since my Lord has raised that.
The ECP has not
yes. not placed yes,
the entire record.
The not responsibility. No responsibility is upon you to submit the record. Where is that record?
Let me show, my lord.
But you say that the election commission has.
No, kindly see. I am submitting that we be treated as independents who have joined SIC. But jee, main uska jawab de dun how they have suppressed the record. Kindly see.
Bata de raha.
Jee, kindly see in CMA 5840, part 2, from pages 168 onwards, they have chosen to file my nomination papers. They've somehow, from all the candidates available, they thought they would attack me because I'm appearing as counsel. So they've filed my nomination papers from page 168 onwards. And I take your lordships, the court.
I'm a bit confused. Who are you representing right now?
PTI.
Kawal Shawzeb as well as PTI.
When you talk about the petitioner, the candidate, please be specific. Then you say I'm arguing on behalf of PTI.
Murad. Kawal Shawzeb is the chairman, president of the women's wing of the PTI.
Her case is different.
Aapki application hai na bhi jo aapne di.
Ji, maine PTI ki application bhi de di hai. There is no conflict between
which page you want to refer.
Now kindly see, they've placed my nomination papers, me as in Salman Akram Raja, at page 168 onwards. Now this shows my affiliation declaration, page 166 onwards.
Salman Raja, just this question. Now I'm in the context of this application that you've given. I just want to know that PTI had fielded how many candidates to which you had issued certificates for the National Assembly?
I'll get the exact number, but my
figure to batai.
But it's over 170. We were contesting every single.
Everybody was given certificates.
Yes, and that is what I want to now demonstrate. Kindly see pages 166 onwards till 185. 263, Gaur Khan Saab tells me. 263 tickets
across
issued,
Pakistan.
All across Pakistan. Now kindly see at
so what's the, I mean, where do we see this thing?
National Assembly.
Where do we see this thing? Did you put it up somewhere?
Yes, we put out our lists of candidates.
Where is that?
On our websites.
We have is there anything on the record here?
On our website can only be gone through if somebody.
Mr. Salman Akram Raja.
Yes,
we have the record.
Aapki apna bhi declaration nazariyati ka hai.
Main aapko hi dikhana cha raha hoon. Kindly see, bear with me for a moment.
Statutory declaration mein conflict
kyun hai? Ji, main aapko hi dikha raha hoon. जी, kindly see, we start at page 166. 166 से जरा शुरू कीजिए. I filed my nomination paper, and then at page 168, I declare my affiliation to the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf. And then, kindly see, I also with this filed my PTI ticket, which I have now placed for your lordship's perusal, with CMA 5917. Which they have suppressed.
I'm confused. We were at page 184. What is
166? We were at page 166, and then 168.
Then you went us to took
then
us
we
to
go,
one.
We go to 184.
Then you went to 180. What is at 183? There's a statute declaration.
Gee, kindly. So at 183 there is a declaration. At 184 there is.
Why are we seeing these papers? You're not telling us that.
Yes, to show that they have suppressed the record. Supposedly, they claim they filed my entire nomination papers and the supporting documents, but they have not done so. I will just demonstrate that in a moment. At page 185, we dekh lijiye, which is the withdrawal of the Nazriyati ticket and the certificate. At page 185, within minutes, I withdrew. It was given, and then I immediately withdrew it. And they accept the withdrawal. But what they suppress from the court is what is available in CMA 5917.
A second, you need to pull that out. 5917.
You have withdrawn. Kiya uske baad aapko kya tasavvur kiya jaye? Ye to nahi likha aapne
isme. Bear with me. Kindly see.
They're independent page, or PTI.
Page 23 pe aaiye. Zara 5917 ke. Sorry, not 23 is Kamal Shawzeb. My own.
Page 5917. What do we should we see on 5917?
Page 144. Page 144. 144 pe aa jayenge. This is the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf ticket issued to me. Kindly see at page 144.
Mr. Salman Akram Raja, we are dealing with the case of Ms. Shawzeb Kamal, not yours.
No, but they have chosen to file my documents. I'm just demonstrating suppression. I'm just demonstrating that they have suppressed documents. Now, at page 144 is my ticket.
5914 mein kaun sa page hai? 5914 mein.
5917 mein. CMA 5917, page 144.
5917 nikalo.
Point I'm making is that the documents that they filed are not the complete documents which were filed before the ROs.
Now, but one thing...
The date of submission is 13th January?
PG 13th January.
No, 13th January is not. 12th January.
No, sir, kindly see niche just the...
No, upar, no, you look upar.
No,
you... No, you... No, you... ऊपर जो तारीख
मुझे इशू हुआ 12 जनवरी को
12 जनवरी को आप स्टैट्यूटरी डिक्लेरेशन फाइल कर रहे हैं 13 जनवरी को और नजरियाती दिखा रहे हैं
मैं अर्ज कर रहा हूं ना सर मुझे अर्ज करनी थी ये 12 जनवरी को मुझे इशू हुआ 13 जनवरी को मैंने ये फाइल कर दिया नीचे आप देखिए रिसीविंग है दिस इज द रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर अगर आप इनकी से
रिसीविंग को छोड़िए ना मगर डॉक्यूमेंट तो एग्जिस्टिंग कर रहा था जब आप स्टैट्यूटरी डिक्लेरेशन फाइल कर रहे हैं
मुझे अर्ज करने दें आई एम जस्ट शोइंग द सप्रेशन ऑन देयर पार्ट लीगल इंप्लिकेशंस आर अ सेपरेट मैटर व्हाई हैव दे नॉट फाइल्ड दिस टिकट This ticket is in fact even discussed in the 2nd February 2024 order passed by the...
But you filed it now. Make the point.
The point is simply this, that they have suppressed the record.
Let's go ahead, please.
Let's ask you, kindly. This is a very important point because this entire chart that they filed becomes very suspicious when your lordships realize that this chart is based on suppression of documents.
On sir, page
144.
Whatever they filed.
Sir, mujhe arz karne de, ekname ke liye. It's very important. They have filed a chart and they have said itne logon ne sirf ticket jama
karaya. I think it's a very important in this particular case
submission.
Because the questions have been raised
about
regarding the fairness of the elections. And the role of the election commission itself.
I'm grateful,
if it can suppress some material information from us.
From the Supreme Court, kindly see. So my ticket was duly filed with my nomination papers.
Page 144,
sir. 144 of CMA 5917. Mujhe inhone kaha ki hum ye receive hi nahi karte aapse ticket. Because your party has not been... declared entitled to a symbol. So they tried to return this to me. I being the lawyer, I insisted. I said, no, you have to take it and give me a receipt that I've given you this ticket. That is why the RO signed it. The signatures that the court will see at page 144, dated 13-1-2024, are identical to the signatures at page 185, where I withdraw the Nazriyati ticket. So what happened was, this ticket was filed. Then they said, sorry, we will not treat you as PTI candidates because the Supreme Court judgment is there. So withdraw your tickets. They actually returned the tickets. I refused to take it back. I said, no, I'm not going to take my ticket back. You, in fact, give me a receipt that I filed my ticket. And that is why this receipt was given to me. And yet when they filed these documents with their CMA, they suppressed this ticket to say, I only filed...
Mr. Raja, you used the word... 3-4 times. Can we make the point now?
Point is that the record filed by them is not reliable. Now let
me come. Fine. Then is there anything preventing? The matter is being contested in open court. The document is on record. Yes. If any party disagrees, disbelieves with a document, they can file their document.
No, I've shown from this instance that the documents they have filed are
there
not
are in your possession. I'm sure everybody makes photocopies. Parties could have brought those on record.
But they're in their possession also. All I'm showing is that documents in their possession
can get on with the case.
Not being filed. Yes, my lord. Now, let me come to my 7 points. I was going to do this at the very end, but I've done it.
Mr. Raja, kisi zamane mein government or constitutional bodies bona fide litigants samjhe jaate
the. Ji.
Ab to ECPP mukadma jeetne aayi hai like an ordinary litigant.
They are acting as if there are adversaries. They should be independent, impartial
Instead
arbiters of the election process.
They have come before us to behaving like an ordinary litigant.
Absolutely.
They want to win the case.
Their interest should be, I bow, their interest should be to give effect to the will of the people. I don't see that happening. The suppression of documents in the case they have chosen to highlight. I have not chosen to file my documents. They filed my documents forcing me to file my
tickets.
Now let me read through my points. Hopefully within 10 minutes. Number one, Kawal Shozab's right to file the appeal and be heard. She heads the PTI Women's Wing. She was one of two whose name was included in the list for women's reserved seats filed by PTI. SIC has confirmed that she remains a leading contender in case seats are allowed to SIC. She is directly affected by the outcome of the proceedings before the SC. And I refer to pages 7 and 23 of CMA 5917, in which the list in which her name is included, the women's seats list that PTI filed is there. And at page 23 is the Sunni Ittehad Council certificate recognizing her as a leading contender for a women's seat, if they are allowed. So she is not just anybody off the street.
Please, aage badhiye.
Ji, sir, I...
I mean, what's the point in making these statements off the street?
Lord, allow me to...
I mean, even if she's off the street, she's the highest respect. Ye baatein na karein.
Sir, aage badhiye, please. She's not entitled to maintain.
Please, aage badhiye.
Now, a political party can gain a general seat in two ways. Either when one of its ticket holders is declared successful as a result of polling, this would be a directly won seat, or an independent joins it. So general seats can be acquired in two ways. Either way, the party is said to have secured or won a general seat. The sole purpose of the proviso in Article 51.6 is to clarify, 51.6d I should say, is to clarify that independents joining a party will be treated as seats won by that party. Nowhere does Article 51.6 speak of directly won general seats. That's a very important distinction. Directly won seats are on polling day. Other seats won are when independents join. They're both general seats. Reserved seats are to be allowed on the basis of general seats. Number three, the issue of the grant or otherwise of reserved seats to SIC turns on how the phrases each political party and such political party as used in Article 51.6d and e are interpreted along with the words secured and includes. There is no clear statement that only parties with at least one directly elected seat may be allowed a reserved seat. The interpretation made must advance the basic purpose of the Constitution, which is a representative National Assembly based on facilitation of political parties in the electoral process and the affairs of the House. Granting reserved seats to other parties in a proportion greater than the general seats won would make the National Assembly unrepresentative. Number four. The judgment of the Peshawar High Court is based on its interpretation of the word includes, and I refer to paragraphs 15 to 17 of that judgment in particular. I draw the court's attention to paragraphs 15 to 17 of the Peshawar High Court judgment. It has held that since in interpretation clauses, the word includes does not imply exclusivity, it cannot imply exclusivity in Article 51.6. It excludes political parties that exclusively consist of independents who have joined them. So this is the reasoning that...
You want to say that PTI, you say that those who have gone to Sunni Ittehad are okay.
Absolutely okay. Because we are independent.
You don't want it.
No, sir. We have independent when declared. After that, we have joined Sunni Ittehad in accordance with the law. We were declared independent. उससे पहले जो भी हुआ वो इलेक्शन कमीशन की गलती है. For that we can't be faulted. So I am making a case that once we were declared independent, we duly joined Sunni Ittehad, and once we joined Sunni Ittehad,
आपका स्टेटमेंट जरा एक दफा फिर आप सोच लें.
सपोज बिल्कुल सोच
सपोज अगर हम इस नतीजे पे पहुंचे कि वो गलत गए थे एसआईसी में
जी
तो आपको नहीं चाहिए.
नहीं सर देखिए द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हैज टू बी इंटरप्रेटेड.
ऐसा नहीं हो सकता आप या चाहेंगे या नहीं चाहेंगे.
नो सर यू विल अप्लाई द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. माय प्रेयर इज नॉट गोइंग टू constrain your interpretation of the Constitution. Agar aap samjhenge ki in these circumstances I should be allowed seats as PTI, I will not refuse, obviously. But I am simply stating that acting on how the Election Commission treated us, they declared us independents, we therefore had no option but to join the Sunni Ittehad Council. We could not have rejoined PTI because Barrister Gohar...
Whether that declaration by the Election Commission was correct?
In my opinion, not. I challenged it, sir. I challenged it. But that is where it stands. So because we were declared independent, we joined the Sunni Ittehad Council, and on that basis, we are claiming the benefit of Article 51.6d and e, where there is no language ousting parties that only have seats on account of independents joining them. There is no language. And the Peshawar High Court, in fact, says it is adopting purposive interpretation. They somehow find the purpose of the Constitution to be to facilitate parties with one directly elected seat. Nothing in the Constitution says that. So in fact, the entire argument regarding purposive versus literal interpretation works in my favor. Where is the language in Article 51.6d that says at least one seat should be won? They're inferring that from the word includes in the Peshawar High Court. And let me read.
सलमान अकरम राजा साहब आपका ये पॉइंट फैसल सिद्दीकी साहब का केस डिमोलिश नहीं कर रहा है.
मुझे नहीं पता सर. आई एम मेकिंग माय पॉइंट. योर लॉर्डशिप्स आर गोइंग टू इंटरप्रेट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड अप्लाई इट. योर लॉर्डशिप्स आर नॉट बाउंड बाय रीडिंग्स. योर लॉर्डशिप्स आर नॉट बाउंड बाय आर्गुमेंट. आई स्टैंड वेयर आई स्टैंड एंड आई से दिस विद ग्रेट कन्विक्शन एंड क्लैरिटी दैट देयर इज नो नीड फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ inference or reading in into Article 51, 6G or E. The language is clear. There is no requirement of one directly elected seat. The Peshawar High Court has read that requirement into Article 51, 6G. Kindly read paragraphs 15 to 17. The interpretation made, I say, must advance the basic purpose of the Constitution, which is a representative parliament. And any other interpretation which reads this requirement of one directly elected seat results, as we can see today, in an entirely unrepresentative parliament. That cannot be the interpretation. I move on.
Raja Sahab, aap ji isi point se, when you talk about representative parliament, it is that fundamental right of the voter.
Yes, my Lord.
In
yes.
the context of that fundamental right of the voter, should this court not correct the grave violation of the entire electoral process by the Election Commission by excluding a political party from the election process?
But all the facts are now before your lordships, and your lordships can make any order that advances and implements the Constitution. We are only here to assist. Your lordships are not bound by my prayer. They are not bound by my arguments. So anything that your lordships feel is the mandate of the Constitution should be granted. Now I move on. Kindly see. The Peshawar High Court, I'm still reading paragraph 4, has called this purposive interpretation by saying that since the word includes and definition clauses does not imply exclusivity, therefore here also in Article 51.6 B, it will not imply exclusivity. Now that's a completely different context. In interpretation clauses or definition clauses, there is often a contest between the word includes and means. We say means this is exhaustive, the definition is exhaustive. Includes means that the definition is not exhaustive. So somehow the Peshawar High Court has taken that distinction to imply that in Article 51, 6 D and E, and a party that consists exclusively of independents who have joined it is not permitted. Now, there is nothing in the Constitution to say that. Kindly read paragraphs 15 to 17 of the Peshawar High Court judgment. In addition, it is submitted that the Peshawar High Court has erred in interpreting the word includes as if it only means added to. The word includes is a general umbrella term. If I say this class includes boys and girls, it does not mean that there has to be at least one boy for girls to be allowed into that class. This course includes both boys and girls. It's simply saying that when everything has been taken into account...
Without a single person, boy or girl...
Yes, anybody can be included.
Baat to suna. Ji. Kisi bache aur bachi ke baghair... Class hoga.
No, wo ye keh rahe hai ki aap join kar lenge.
Isi ko join karenge.
So join kisko karenge? A political party. A political party exists outside parliament. We know political parties exist outside parliament. So I'm submitting there is no language. Your lordships will have to introduce something to the language in order to create this restriction. I read on. It is submitted that the Peshawar High Court has erred in interpreting the word includes as if it only means added to. The word includes is a general term used to describe the members of a category. It does not necessarily mean addition to something that exists. Dictionaries may be consulted. I've placed a number of dictionaries which, if I may be allowed, I'll just hand over. That the word includes never or very rarely means added to. Number 5, the ECP order merely assumes that reserved seats can only be granted to parties that have won at least one seat during polling. I find no real reasoning in the ECP order. The Peshawar High Court at least tries to provide some reasoning, but the ECP assumes that this is the situation. This departs from the reading of Article 51.6 by the ECP in 2019 when BAP was allowed reserved seats even though it had neither contested the election. I'm told it had contested, but it had not won. But it had certainly not filed lists of names for reserved seats. So, to that extent, I make an amendment here.
Peshawar High Court mein bhi aapka PTI ne to koi case nahi lada na, Peshawar High Court mein, wahan bhi SIC.
Ji, SIC lada rahi hai, we're very clear.
Paragraph 22 jo hai, page 47 pe, yehi baat jo yahan ho rahi hai, wo Peshawar High Court ne bhi aapko jawab diya hai.
Theek ho gaya, I'm saying on that basis.
These PTI-backed independent candidates who won these seats,
who have joined the SIC,
are not pleading claim before us today. To wo Peshawar High Court ke saamne
bhi yehi baat. Theek ho gaya, I'm not departing from what has been argued, that's a matter of record. But I'm submitting that once the independents or those declared independents have joined, they were entitled to seats, even if there were no lists filed prior to the polling day, and even if that party had not won any seats. This was done in 2019 when BAP was allowed, and the Election Commission was then led by retired Justice Sardar Raza. There was deliberation. We cannot say that this reading of Article 51(6) in 2019 was entirely illusory, is something that no rational, sane person could have done. It was a rational interpretation arrived at, and there is no reason today to depart from that interpretation, particularly when in the facts and circumstances that we now face, it will lead to an entirely unrepresentative National Assembly as well as the provincial assemblies of at least KP and Punjab. So the point in referring to the BAP case is simply to say this was a reasonable interpretation, and that reasonable interpretation can be adopted even today. It may not be binding, but it was reasonable. And if something is reasonable, then it is not excluded. So far, the Election Commission has acted as if this is a self-evident truth that at least one seat should have been won. That 86 plus 1 is equal to 87, but 86 plus 0 is equal to 0. This was not the interpretation made in 2019 and should not be the interpretation made today. I move on. Number 6. The Attorney General had to rely on Article 63A, Clause 2, to read the requirement of at least one seat directly won into Article 51(6). So I found the argument made by the learned Attorney General interesting. He felt that reading 51(6) with 63A, Clause 2, gives us the basis for saying that there should be at least one seat. And his argument was that it talks about a parliamentary party. And the question was raised that when does a parliamentary party come into existence? And the answer was that within the three-day period, if people, independents, have joined a political party, then thereafter, as soon as they take oath, they become members of the parliamentary party. Nothing more is needed. No procedure is given. So in the three-day period, these independents joined the SIC. When they took oath, SIC became a parliamentary party. So nothing is inconsistent about, you know, the way things have happened. And the Election Commission, therefore, accepted the SIC as a parliamentary party. And it accepted it during that three-day period also as a political party that may be joined. So when declarations were filed under Rule 92, Clause 6, that was read at length a little while ago, they accepted those declarations and said, yes, this is a political party that you can join within that three-day period. So that entire reading of the Constitution, of the rules of the Election Act, cannot now be declared a mistake or an arbiter only to oust us. So this reliance or reference to Article 63A is entirely irrelevant. A parliamentary party came into existence when those who had joined within 3 days took oath and became members of the National Assembly. They became a parliamentary party. Number 7. The reading of Section 104 of the Election Act 2017 is dependent on the reading of Article 51(6). If parties consisting of independents who had not contested can be allowed reserved seats, then Section 104 must be read to allow opportunity to such parties to file lists and nomination papers after the polling day and announcement of the results of the directly won seats. So if your lordships and my lady were to come to the conclusion that the SIC members, as a result of independents joining them or those declared independent joining them, are entitled to reserved seats, then there is no restriction in Article 51(6) as to the time when the lists and the nomination papers are to be filed. Even Section 104 in its own language does not say when this is to happen. So we can file lists tomorrow, they can have a 4-day scrutiny period, and the whole process can move further. There is no impediment at all. Now, just for a moment again, going back to the facts that I've stated in CMA 5913 on behalf of PTI, I will not read these, it's just 3 or 4 pages, but these may very kindly be looked at. This will explain what happened. The Nazriati ticket was filed because we were told your PTI tickets are not acceptable. So we had no option then. We were desperately trying to give the people of Pakistan an opportunity to vote for the party that they want to vote. And it was our fear that if each constituency, a National Assembly constituency in Punjab at least, has one NA candidate and 5 provincial assembly candidates underneath, 6 different symbols in one constituency. This is the election we had to fight ultimately. So in order to prevent that from happening, we went for the Nazriati in the hope that we would have a common election symbol. But that was quashed both by the election commission, the order that Faisal Siddiqui Saab just read, and I actually on my own felt uncomfortable. So I gave it, and within 5 minutes I took it back. I said, no, come what may, I'm going to contest as PTI.
Since you keep bringing your person into the matter,
they filed my papers, sir. They filed my papers.
Can you just let for the question? If I ask you today, because there's a statutory declaration which says you belong to Nazriya.
I know what my law is saying. There's a reason why I'm interrupting with great respect. This is a matter before the courts. I would request my lord not to make any comment.
Please, it's not a comment, it's a question.
My lord.
The statute declaration which shows you as Nazirati, there's a certificate which you referred to which shows you as PTI, and now you're saying you are... can you just tell me which political party you belong to?
I do not want to respond to this question. I remain PTI.
You are not before us.
Yes,
you're not before us.
So you are. You keep referring to yourself.
They filed my papers. I don't know why.
You are partyless. I mean, it's not a state secret. It's a factual plea.
But me, the person Salman Akram Raja, is not relevant. I will, with great respect, not answer that question at the moment.
We are asking you which political party.
As far as Kamal Shauzab is concerned, she is PTI and she will join SIC is allowed seats. I'm very grateful for that opportunity. I've done my duty. I've placed my points before the court. It's for the court to decide.
आपसे भी सच नहीं बोला जा रहा
है। सच बिल्कुल बोला जा रहा है।
2018 में
जी
PMLN के साथ वही हो रहा था जो आज PTI के साथ हो रहा है। And nobody speaks the truth. This is something known to everyone.
And that is
how constitution should be interpreted to uphold the democratic principles and the structure, and particularly the rights of those voters who have been wronged.
CMA 5913 states all of that. I urge the court to read my CMA 5913 on behalf of PTI. We've explained what we were facing.
Or anything left?
I'm very grateful for that opportunity.
Everyone concluded?
Yes.
Chal. Reserve. Speak. Isme likhiye.
I don't need.
Acha theek hai, reserved hai bas. Reserved hai. Isme likhiye. Chal.
Chal. Conclude kar sakte
or it will be a long order. Anyways, we haven't discussed, so we can't say anything. It will be reserved.
Very kind, very grateful to all your lordships and to you, ladyship. Thank you, sir.